Hello people, today I'm going to be talking about a subject that everybody from Jamaica is quite aware of, corruption. Corruption in Jamaica is as long-standing as jerk chicken. Corruption in Jamaica has been embedded so strongly into the Jamaican culture that Jamaicans and some people around the world has already accept as a part of the Jamaican culture. And even though corruption is rife in Jamaica, you know, my aim is to use my voice, use my channel to inspire others to try to eliminate the corruption. You know, and corruption it's a wide platform. So it's not just one thing that I could say is the main corruption. You know, corruption breeds corruption. And recently I've been looking into what's going on in Jamaica in order to stay abreast with the current affairs and to have relevant information to discuss in this channel. So I'm gonna cover two spectrums of corruption that I've recently came across in Jamaica. And the first one I'm gonna cover is the violence. Violence is renowned in Jamaica. You know, it's a very shameful fact, but facts are facts. Unfortunately, this violence doesn't only come from private citizens. This violence comes also from the security forces, which includes the police and the soldiers in Jamaica. It's a shame, but most Jamaicans, including myself, will say to you that a great percentage of the security force in Jamaica are equal criminals as the bandits and the outlaws or the underworld or the gangsters or whatever you want to call them. Some of the security forces members are just as guilty for murder and theft. But before I express my fact to that claim, let me just brief you on what I came across recently. Recently in Jamaica, two men, gunmen, according to the news, there was a shootout in Arborview, and one of the men died and one was injured, and while taken to the Kingston Public Hospital, on arrival he was pronounced dead. That is a familiar news report to Jamaicans. That is nothing new. Ever since I was a little kid in Jamaica, growing up in Jamaica, listening to the news or becoming aware of the realities that surround me, it's a common thing to hear on the radio. It's dead upon arrival. It's very rare, if ever, that a gunman has been shot, injured, taken to the hospital, and is awaiting transfer to go to the lockup or the jail to go through due process. I mean, Jamaican law enforcement, they take their badge, they take their power that has been entrusted in them, and they abuse it and they murder their own people. They do not believe in due process. They do not believe in law and order. They believe because they were given a gun, they have a right to take another person's life. Keep in mind, a police officer and soldier, they're instruments of the law. They were appointed to carry out the law. And where police officers are concerned, it was appointed unto them to serve the people, to protect the people, to preserve life. Police officers were appointed to be mediators of clashes or conflicts. Their main purpose is to keep the peace. But in Jamaica, that is not so. In Jamaica, police officers take more lives on a percentage level, probably more than any other country in the world. In another news, one of Jamaica's most wanted was recently captured. I think his name was Ratty. And according to what I've read, this guy has been a menace to the society. He has killed several people, he has taken lives, and he's driven fear through his local neighborhood. He was located and cornered, and he got killed. He died. However, the news sent it across, he died. To many Jamaicans, that's not a surprise. And before anybody get on my case, let's face it, I understand that if you have lost a loved one by the hands of this guy, it's a rejoiceful moment to you. The Bible says, an eye for an eye. And Jamaica is a very religious society where the Bible is concerned and Christianity is concerned. But at the same time, y'all got to keep in mind that there is a court system, there is a legal system, there is due process under the Jamaican Constitution. And my aim is to enforce that due process, is to preserve life in Jamaica. I'm not saying this guy, particularly Ratty, deserved to live, and I'm not saying he also deserved to die. No one makes me judge or jury. I'm just using his case as an example that it's no surprise that when someone who's wanted in Jamaica get cornered by the law enforcement, 9 times out of 10, they're usually dead. Where the prisons are concerned in Jamaica, it would be interesting for me to know the percentage of inmates in Jamaican prison who actually was caught with a gun or who actually was charged for murder and was actually arrested with gun in their possession that are still alive. Because to my knowledge, most, if not all, what we call bad men, gunmen in Jamaica, when they are approached, when they are cornered by law enforcement, the police officers and the soldiers usually become judge and jury. And that in itself is unconstitutional. That in itself is actually murder. In another news, there was a girl that seemed to have reached out to Amnesty International, or Amnesty International has reached out to her. I believe her name was Shackeila Jackson. She's from Kingston in the Orange Villa area, and her brother was shot last year and killed. The guy actually runs a legitimate business. He actually runs a local restaurant, and he was approached by the police officer in his place of business, and the police officer said, "You look like someone who committed a robbery some time ago, according to your description." Okay, let's say, I'm not saying this guy was the perpetrator who committed the robbery, but just for example's sake, let's say this guy was actually the perpetrator, and now you cornered him. So in his vicinity of business, where you only have pots and pans, knives, spoons, and fork, I mean, give me the justification why you would shoot someone like that close range and kill him. There's no justice in that. You know, and the police officer or police officers who are responsible for that are supposed to be prosecuted. They're supposed to be going to court. They're supposed to stand in front of a judge. No one in Jamaica should be above the law, including those people that carry a badge. I'm from Jamaica. And I understand the corruption in Jamaica is rife. I have the fortunate and unfortunate experience of living in both classes of Jamaica. I've lived in the hood. I was born in the hood. And I see things happen in the hood. I've experienced things with my eyes. Most of what some Jamaicans have read in the paper when I was a child, I witnessed that. I've seen police come to our neighborhood, corner the so-called Don or the so-called bad man, and I've watched those people on their knees plea and beg for their life, and police kill them right in front of all the citizens. And police did that without regard, because it is known that most people of the ghettos are ignorant, or they don't know what action to take. But now that I'm an adult and I understand democracy and I understand the Constitution of Jamaica, I'm trying to be a voice to help people to help themselves. When your loved ones or your children have been murdered like that, you have a responsibility to file a civil suit. A civil suit for unlawful debt, a civil suit for rights violation, a civil suit for inhumanity, or a civil suit for prejudice, or anything just to get those people in front of a court to pay some penalty. It doesn't matter how much money you're rewarded, it will never replace your loved ones. But you, as a citizen in Jamaica, have a right to file a petition to the court, whether you want to do it yourself or you want to do it through a lawyer who understands the law more. But you have to take action. Don't let Jamaican police officers or law enforcement body believe that they have the right to murder your loved one or murder your children or murder your friends. I want Jamaican people to start taking action. I understand that corruption is rife. Living in the ghetto, when I live in the ghetto and I see people call the police, sometimes police take up to a whole day, sometimes 2 days before they show up. And when I lived uptown in the suburbs of Jamaica, police showed up within seconds, within minutes, sometimes before you even hang up the phone, police officers are at the doorstep. So I understand that bias, I understand that prejudice, I understand that the police officer respond to the people uptown faster than they'll respond to the people downtown. That in itself is another subject that needs to be addressed, but at this time I just want to address the corruption that's in Jamaica. Robert Montague, Jamaican Minister of National Security, his life is being threatened because Robert Montague is doing his job. It's not a lot of Jamaican politician that I give thumbs up to, but I give thumbs up to Robert Montague for being a whistleblower, for saying, okay, my investigation or my knowledge have led me to find out that the guns are coming from the US to this country, to Haiti, to Jamaica. It's his job. That's his job. His job is to eliminate all criminal aspect. And now that Robert Montague has blown that whistle, Jamaica has to take extra precaution because the member of parliament, the Minister of National Security, is being threatened because he's doing what he was appointed to do. This is ridiculous. Keeping it with member of parliament, this is how deep corruption has gone in Jamaica. Peter Bunting issued a certificate of immunity for 3 soldiers in Jamaica who was initially charged for murder. Here's how ridiculous this is. 4 years after the soldier were charged for murder, Peter Bunting believed the timing was appropriate to issue immunity. Now, if you don't call that corruption, I don't know what is. I understand that the Justice Department is fighting that immunity and saying it's an interruption of due process. I agree that it's corruption. I understand that Peter Bunting's attorney would say it's a false claim and it's not corruption. That's his job. His job is to defend his client. So whether his clients are guilty of anything, he's a defense attorney. He's supposed to find loopholes to say his client isn't guilty. But where the Constitution is concerned, where Jamaican justice is concerned, Peter Bunting is guilty of corruption. You're guilty of trying to interrupt due process. That's just how deep corruption has been rooted in Jamaica. It's due time that police officers, soldiers, members of parliament, members of the government body in a whole be brought up for criminal charges. No one in Jamaica should be above the law. I don't have anything personally against the law enforcement in Jamaica. I have friends that are in the law enforcement of Jamaica. I have friends that are of high ranking position in Jamaican police force. So it's not that I'm being biased. It's not that I don't like Jamaican police or I don't like the idea of security forces. Even if my friends, the ones that I consider my friends, are found to be that they are breaching law and they're not serving and they're not protecting and they're going around murdering people, we would no longer be friends. And I would definitely be on the opposing side of them. The whole purpose is to let Jamaicans live. Let them live. Teach them. Try to guide them. Try to protect them. I don't condone violence. I don't condone murders. I don't understand why Jamaican young men believe that, well, the gun is the answer and we should go around killing each other for one reason or another. You know, I don't understand that and I'm not trying to understand it. I just want to give big props to Robert Montague for doing his job as a Minister of National Security. And I want to give a big shout out to Shackeila Jackson for reaching out to Amnesty or accepting the invitation from Amnesty to voice her story. I feel for you. I understand the struggle. I've seen it. I've witnessed it. I've been a victim of it. You know, not me personally, you know, but I've lost family members in Jamaica by the hands of police officers for no real justified cause, and nothing comes out of it. Nothing happened. Those police officers went on with their careers until they've probably retired by now, you know. So I'm personally sick and tired of it, to know that those things are still going on in Jamaica. And I'm just encouraging other Jamaicans that step up. We have one life to live. Don't be afraid. Speak your mind. You can actually make a change. A coward man may live a long time, but what's the point of living if your life serves no real purpose? We all are here for a purpose. Find your purpose. Find your voice. Say what you have to say. Be the change that you want to see. And that's pretty much my message today. I hear a lot of people say they're proud to be Jamaicans. And I often wonder, in what aspect are you proud to be Jamaican? You know, are you proud to be Jamaican because it produced reggae music, jerk chicken, Bob Marley, Usain Bolt? Or are you proud to be Jamaican because it's a beautiful country with coral reefs, sunshine, white sand beaches, and beautiful vegetation? Because we can't be proud to be Jamaicans if we are saying we're proud to be Jamaican because on an overall basis, we're just happy how our country is. We're just happy for the example that our country is making to the rest of the world. We need to start resurrecting the Constitution and the rule of Jamaica. Let the people who are in charge of law and order go in their boxes and go in their files and dust off all those documents, those words that was written to protect us, to give us a place called home in Jamaica. I hope that my voice and my message today was of some help or some motivation to one of you, two of you, or thousands of you. Until next time, peace.